G'day guys, back again. Yeah guys, I hear those whispers. I hear them at the hobby show, the competition tables, when I walk past the hobby shops. I see the little smirks behind my back and the little giggles when I leave the vendors' tables at the hobby shows. I hear you all saying, now why hasn't Brisbane Mole Builder done a review of a Gunstar yet? Well, I'll tell you why. They're pretty hard to get, and luckily I was lucky enough to pick up this little fella from Starship Modeler a couple of years ago. And you can also pick up another one from, I think it's Monsters in Motion, isn't it? And that is a little bit of a larger one. I actually thought it was 135 scale of Monsters in Motion one when they first advertised it, but then I saw it a little while ago and it had 148. So I don't know if they've done two versions of it, or if there was one originally 135, or whether I've just got mixed up. But this one here is 172, and if you're looking for the right one to pick, I would pick this one. I've got both. I'll do a review of the other one later on, but this is definitely the one to pick up. So it's done by Black Sun Models. As I said, it's 172 scale. It's a resin kit. And as you can see in the picture there, it includes metal landing gear, which is always nice. Hopefully that's a little bit stronger than our resin, being so thin and all. And we also have the two clear canopies. Let's have a look in the box. Now, as I said before, I picked this up on Starship Modeler through the shop there a couple of years ago, so if it's not there now, don't be surprised. And I think I also saw the news on Model Geek. And there's also a feature by Duncan Scott on Model Geek as well. He's done a photo feature on it. So if you get on and have a look around on Model Geek, you will see a very, very nice job. Probably one of the best ones I've seen so far of this kit built up. And there's not a lot out there, so check his out. Duncan Scott on Model Geek. And don't you just love the picture they've got on this piece of paper? Kind of reminds me of something like from Blake 7 meets Fifth Element, something like that. It's a very cool design. Here's a nice sheet of paper here telling you about the decals. And you can laugh at me again, guys, but I hadn't even seen the last Starfighter. I saw the ship on the internet before I even had seen the movie, so just goes to show how Mole can help promote movies. I end up searching for the movie after I'd seen this ship, and then I watched the movie, and yeah, what can you say? It's a pretty old movie, guys. It's a bit like, you know, in the era of Buck Rogers or something like that. So for its time, it's not a bad movie, and I wouldn't complain about it. It's definitely not a theatre movie now, but I'm sure for its time, just like Buck Rogers, it would have been a pretty cool movie. And here we have the decals here. We're doing this a bit backwards. Here's the front page of the instructions. Here's a layout of all the parts. So due to this, I'll do a close-up of this. And I don't know if I'll be lying all my parts out. Excuse me. Lying all the model parts out on the table. Just obviously because of these photos, so I'll zoom in here and show you these. As you can see here, I've said in some of my other videos, I really appreciate when a model manufacturer actually prints out all the parts for you, especially in like a resin or garage type kit, just so you actually know you've got all the parts. I'm sure a lot of you, when you get a model, you pull it out and check that all the parts are there, especially if it's sort of like a rare kit or you've bought it from overseas. You might want to check to see if all the parts are there. So it's nice when they do this for you. Makes it a lot easier. Another picture of the parts there. And there's your canopies down the bottom there. So how cool is this? Gotta love it when they give you a bit of a nameplate to put on the base of your kit or the base of your stand if you want to put it in a competition or just have it as a display in your house. It's a nice touch. Alrighty, we're back on the instructions. Obviously you can just pause these guys. I'll flip through them reasonably quickly. As I've said before, I do like getting some weird and wonderful kits that you don't see every day in the model competitions or model shows. It's nice to put something on the table that people don't see every day. There's the last page there. And as I said before, guys, I'm not going to pull out all the parts. I just thought I'd show you, obviously, the quality of the resin casting. And because you obviously won't get that from the pictures. And I thought we could just have a look at a couple of parts. But straight out of the bags, the casting on this is unbelievable. Fantastic. Really, really impressed. Compared to the Monsters in Motion kit, definitely get this one. Without a doubt. Let's check out some parts. You can see the detail on this one. Beautiful. Beautiful casting. I mean, check that out. I don't really need to say much. But you get a nice kit, pretty much just showing you. Really does all the talking. I like this piece here. It's actually so well done, it feels more just like a plastic kit done by Tamir or something like that. It's just got a really nice quality about it. I mean, this piece here just feels like part of a plastic kit. Just the quality of the casting on this and how clean it is. Look at that. Again, same with this piece here. I have definitely no complaints with this kit. And even though it's 172 scale, it's going to end up being a reasonably sized kit. I mean, even just the width here where I've just put these parts down here is roughly around 22 centimeters in width. So 172 scale, it's still going to be a nice size. And here's the signage here for the Gunstar. And it's nice that they've given that to you so you can just slap that down on your base. It's a very nice touch. There you have it, guys. Sorry I didn't go through all the parts, but given that it was laid out on that the diagram pictures I showed you, I didn't really think there was too much of a point going through all the parts. Just was really letting people know that this kit was out there. And if anyone was interested, they could try and track one down. Hope you enjoyed this very short opening of the box. Happy modelling, guys, and I'll catch you later.